people here are having trouble to choose. We would do a tiebreaker now, and I want you to make us understandable what's the difference between both of you.
The financing of the what he talks calls a Green New Deal and what I call a Green New Deal is different.
Yes.
And his financing is based on the idea the European Central Bank buys bonds from the European Investment Bank. In Germany, this...
Maybe I can introduce my policy and then you can criticize it.
Please. No, please let...
If you introduce my policy, what is my job?
You can do it as well. You can turn it around then afterwards. But what I want to say is, in the German public debate, even if I agree that European central banks can be used in order to finance common goods, in the German debate, this is absolutely toxic. If we do this, we would have not a smaller, but a much larger AfD. And this is why the German Greens and the European Greens asked for ending the tax competition game and use the money from a common company taxation to finance the Green New Deal. Was it unfair, Yanis?
Incomplete. What we're saying is, to begin with, it's important first to work out what is the minimum funding that a genuine green transition requires. How much money do we need to spend on the green transition? We have to work it out. Because, you know, the Fridays for Future people, when the adults are behaving like children, the children grow up to look at us as adults and point a finger at us and say, you're not doing enough. And they are right. What is enough? The minimum of enough is 5% of European GDP. That's 500, Eurozone GDP, let's say. That's about 500 billion every year. That's a minimum that we need to spend to have a genuine green transition in energy, transport, industry, and, of course, agriculture. Where does the money come from? Will it come from taxation, from harmonizing taxes, which are, of course, we are completely in agreement with? We need to do that. But the most you are going to get over a period of 3, 4, 5 years, by the time you do that, is about 50 billion over 3, 4, 5 years.
No.
Really not enough.
No.
By the time you harmonize it and you start collecting the tax. Now, let me complete my story and then you can rebut it. What we are saying is, as we speak now, there is something between 2.5 and 3 trillion euros in the financial circuits of the European Union that is doing nothing but harm. It is beating up house prices in Berlin and Hamburg. It is beating up equities, share values, because companies borrow it in order to buy back their own shares. It's doing nothing productive and nothing green. What we are suggesting is that the European Investment Bank, which belongs to all of us, issues bonds of 500 billion every year, and the European Central Bank makes an announcement, effectively remind us of what it is already doing, Sven. This is not a new idea. That it will buy them if there is a need to prop up their price, if there is a need. By making that announcement, it will not have to buy them. Suddenly, we have 500 billion every year to invest in the Green Energy Union to stop Germany relying on lignite and so on and so forth. With one stroke, you have a substantial amount of money, money that can be mobilized and pressed into the service of the environment and good quality jobs in Germany, in Greece, in Portugal, tomorrow morning, within the rules and within the treaties. And that is our Green New Deal.
Yeah. The problem is, after I read your program, of course, I asked progressive lawyers, is this legal in the treaty what you are proposing?
Of course it is.
And the view of progressive lawyers is, if politicians demand and states demand from the central bank in the framework of now a legislation or in the framework of an election campaign to commit on a 5-year buying program announcement, this would be illegal and would be seen as breaking European law. We need economic programs which allow investments in the green transition to happen. We don't need a new financing program. There's lots of money in the market, but we need to allow a policy which makes finally environmental destruction unprofitable and green investments profitable.
The proposal that I put forward, that we put forward, is entirely legal. And let me tell you how I know it. I didn't ask any lawyer. When I was a governor, I was a governor of the European Investment Bank back in 2015. And that proposal I put to the board of governors of the European Investment Bank. And I can tell you there wasn't a single voice in the board of directors of governors of the European Investment Bank who said that it is illegal. Indeed, Werner Hoyer, the president, was very much in favor of it. But the European Investment Bank cannot do it on its own. It needs the green light from the European Union Council. Now, you are quite right. If we have a formal directive to the European Central Bank, buy those bonds, then you violate the independence pretense of the European Central Bank. But what I'm telling you is that the European Central Bank is already buying those bonds. And Mario Draghi, Benoît Cœuré, and everybody else would love to have more EIB bonds to buy. Look at what they did a month ago. Because they have nothing to buy, they don't have good quality green bonds to purchase. They ended up giving another load of cash to buy rubbish bonds, you know, even McDonald's bonds, you know, Volkswagen diesel bonds, not green bonds. They would love to be able to buy green bonds if there were any, but there aren't any.
Thank you so much. Now we have a much better idea about the differences. Please choose your favorite now. We have a first winner, Yanis Varoufakis. Big applause for the first winner. And our second winner is...